compassionate. Your body will also be compassionate. Speech will be gentle. So this is what we are talking about here. Intention is very important. So no matter, doesn't matter, even small, large action, all depends on the intention. So it means, we used to say in Tibet, if the intention is good, the levels and paths are good. If the intention is bad, the levels and paths are bad. Since everything depends on intention, always make sure they are positive. So before you do any actions, you need a set of intention. Doesn't matter any action, small or large, all depends on the intention. So the intention is good, all the levels and paths are good. Let me tell a story about this. Intentions, if the intention is good, the levels and paths are good. Let me tell, for example, like, there is a story in Tibet, mother and her daughter crossing the river in Tibet. And so both are going to be disappear on the river, there's flood coming. And they both are holding hand together. And mother set up intention, doesn't matter if I die, at least save my daughter. Daughter is thinking, doesn't matter if I died, at least save my mom. Their intention. Both are disappearing in the river. And then, because of this good intention, it is said these both mom and dad born to the good river. So intention set up like that. And also, there are another story in Tibet, we have to cross the river with the little boat, like boatmen and carry the people. And so there are 6 monks and the messenger, want to cross the river. So middle of the river, and then the boatman says, too heavy, They're sick. <Yeah. laughs> And anybody know how to swim, And nobody knew how to swim. He said, if nobody knows how to swim, I'm going to jump, because boat is too heavy. And then, messenger think, one people should jump then enough to carry, So messenger think, I should jump, I should save these 6 months' life, So he jump in the river. Because of this sincere, pure motivation, it is there, this rainbow light appears and save all the lives. So this is, we are talking about intention is very important. So if your intention is good, everything is good. So we used to say in Tibet, everybody, want good. We are talking about good, healthy possessions, good relationship, all talking about, all depends on the karma, If you already accumulated the karma, if you don't want it, will come, natural. You know what I mean? If you already created the karma, because healthy relationship, possessions, wealth, everything depends on the karma. So if you accumulate the karma, it will come natural. Even if you don't want it, it will come. So that's kind of love. Intention doesn't matter. Small, big set of intention before you do the practice. So intention, if the intention is bad, all the even external appears, but intention bad, then all the levels of paths are bad. Let me tell the story just like that. In India, there's a baker, there are so many poor people, and they're sleeping near the king palace. And then he's sleeping near the king. So the whole night, baker is thinking, maybe I should cut the head of the king, and I will become the king. Whole night, this thought. coming in his mind, in his sleep. In the morning, you know, he was sleeping. And the king, so, you know, carriage, right? Carriage coming, and one of will, you know, roll over his neck, cut his neck. And then another story, you know, like, there are two, beautiful story, you know, two, in the sutra, you know, two young Becca, you know, one's name is Kashtra and other name is Brahman, you know, two Becca. So in India, you know, like people invite, you know, Buddha and the monks for the lunch. So one time they invite Buddha and monks invite for the lunch. So these two Becca are waiting for opportunity, you know. So other one, the Brahman, his motivation is no good. So he went before Buddha and monks, he went there, you know. He think I will get more food. But he didn't get any food. But the other one is very waiting, you know. He was waiting on old Buddha and all the monks finished the food. And then he went there, you know, he got plenty of food and very good food, you know. And even he can carry food in the baking bowl, kind of like, so kind of motivation, you know. And then, you know, these two Becca sharing their thoughts on the walking on the road. And then Brahman, this other one, you know, good beggar, said, I wish I have good money like king, you know. I can, you know, make clothing to the monks and I can feed all the monks rest of my life, you know, I want to do good things. So he shared his thought to the other, his beggar. You know. The other beggar shared his thought, I wish I can become the powerful king, you know. And I will execute all the monks, cut, share this thought, you know. And they went different parts of, you know. So their good one went to other country, you know, and he was back sleeping under the tree, you know. And then the king of this country died in India, you know. So they're looking for good people, you know, meritorious, powerful people for the king. So he's sleeping under, and they found him, you know. They appointed him to the king of this you know, land in India, you know. And then he got all money, you know. So he made offering to the monks and Buddha. So other one, you know, so when he was, you know, walking and sleeping on the road, you know, so wagon, right? Wagon will, you know, cut his neck. His neck is cut. So these are his stories. You know. If the intention is good, like the levels of the part are good, so whatever we do, you know, it is very important to set up intention. And also, we are talking about here now.
Number 28 and 29 were not recorded on the thing.
Last
time.
I forgot
to switch it on.
Last time.
Maybe
29. 29
and
30. 29 today? Oh, not recorded?
No, didn't record.
29
and
30. Okay, so here, last time we were talking about how to develop this mindfulness introspection, right? Mindfulness, introspection, and conscientious, these are the most important to control our mind, right? So what we do during meditation time, no problem, we are meditating, right? So when postpone meditation time, then danger, you know, we may lose alertness and mindfulness. Consciousness. So post-meditation, we spend time, you know, then we have to be careful during the post-meditation period. So make sure you are not losing your alertness, mindfulness, and consciousness. So we will be able to control our this. It is not easy to control the mind. So we need different skills and different methods to subdue this mind. So one is, you know, also depends on the, because don't go too extreme to the food. Not very little, not too much. So extreme is maybe if you eat little food, it's not enough to carry your meditation practice. You may lose your practice. If you eat too much, then this will make you heavy, heavy body and heavy mind. So therefore, cut to extremes. Extreme, not too extreme is just enough to maintain your body. So then you will eat this kind of food. So don't go too little, you will lose your energy and you will not carry your practice. If you eat too much, then heavy body, heavy mind, and make your mind foggy, you know, with heavy, you know. So therefore, just eat. And also eat, Lama Tongkapa said, very important to eat healthy food. Food which is suitable for you, you know. Which healthy food. So with whatever food suitable for you, you should eat this food. So this will maintain your, keep your body good energy. So with this good healthy body, healthy mind, you will carry your practice. So one way, this is the one another method. And now after, you know, during meditation sections and post meditation section, now another is when we go to sleep, then we have to be careful, right? So you can transform all sleep to the virtuous actions if you have mindfulness, alertness, and concentration. So therefore, when you are going to sleep, you need set up four thoughts. Four thoughts, very important, Lama Tsongkhapa said. Set up these four thoughts will make your sleep all virtuous, you know, virtuous. The number one thought is appearance of light. So visualizing some kind of light before you go to bed. But in India, you know, yeah, people wash the feet. Everyone walking, no shoes, nothing. You know. So dirty, you know. So wash the feet, and then they go to bed because and sleep like a warrior posture, you know, Buddha. One posture, so loyal posture sleep. You know how to sleep, right? Loyal posture. Because loyal posture does not mean you're sleeping like loyal, okay? It means loyal is a very powerful animal, you know. Can subdue all other animals. So this kind of, you know, attitude, determination, you know. I want to subdue this powerful, unsubdued wild mind, you know, so kind of like that. And then we need to set up four thoughts, right? Appearance of light thought, which is kind of like golden light before you go to bed. So you can imagine golden light, we dispel the ignorance of the mind. When light ignores the darkness. So when you go to, before you go to bed, set up, you know, imagine golden light and dispel the ignorance. And then this is will make your mind more luminous, you know, luminous mind. And then second, then think about recollection. So recollection is number two. Recollection is kind of mindfulness. Whatever you study, whatever you think, whatever you're contemplating in your daily practice. So before you go to bed, you know, whatever you practice day, thinking and contemplating, just make some revisions with the mindfulness. And then third is introspection now. So introspection is before you go to bed, check your mind. If the mind is polluted by the affective emotions, then try to transform to the virtuous activities. So you may think before you go to bed, thought arises, you know, negative mind comes, then transform to the positive virtues. So that's kind of like introspection, alertness. And then fourth thought is arising. Arising is kind of like, so you have this, arising is the, so I will read this Nagarjuna's text, so the letter to the friend. He said, Lord of good family, passing entire day in the first and last watch of the night in the wakefulness, don't let even the time you sleep, because don't let even the time you sleep become fruitless. With mindfulness, sleep only in the middle watch of the night. So he means, so arising. So arising is kind of like thinking all these Buddha's, Lord Buddha's teaching, instruction about teaching, teaching about all the thinking, I will not give up my teachings and, you know, whatever I practice, I will not give up this teaching. Sometimes I may lose, but I will be recharged, you know. I will not let them, you know, this is arising with this motivation, you know. Tomorrow I will wake up. So instead of this, you know, recollection, now introspection, now arising, I will be very courageous and I will put all my effort to success my practice. Means to understand your mind, you know, to understand your ultimate nature of the mind, you know. So it is my main goal is to understand the mind. So mind is within, inside, but I have to recognize this ultimate clear nature of the mind. When I recognize ultimate clear nature of mind, then remember, it's regain your enlightenment. Remember, we often talk about rigpa, you know, awareness. Rigpa, everyone have rigpa, you know. Rigpa is kind of like dzogchen, you know. Rigpa means it is discriminating between our ordinary mind and the mind of awareness. So when we discriminate between these two minds, did you notice that ordinary mind is fluctuating, you know? You can't rely on the ordinary mind. Temporary is changing all the times. Once you realize, oh, Rigpa awareness is never ever changed, you know. It is lasting, beginningless, endless. So we have Rigpa, you know. We have to open this Rigpa. Re-enlightened, you know. We all have this because re-enlightened means through your practice, meditation, you will enlighten the mind. Because temporarily obscured by the disturbing emotions. So, so these disturbing emotions are not nature in the mind. They are like dust on your cloth. You can wash your clothes with dust, right? The dust is not nature in your clothes. They are just like dust. They are temporary. We will, with practice, contemplating, we will remove, because this dust comes and go. They are not nature in the mind. If they are nature in the mind, it is pointless. We will never ever, you know, remove, but they are not nature in the mind, isn't it? So that's kind of like, you know, Rigpa is reawaken, you know, Dzogchen saying reawaken. So we all have Rigpa, you know, but temporarily obscured by the disturbing emotions, through practice, you will open re-enlightenment. So that's the point, isn't it? So that's, so we are talking. Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, talking about, you know, we talk about Buddha, Bodhisattvas, Arya, you know, Dhaka, darkness, all these, even we don't see, they are always there, you know. So they are like witness, so in front of us. So if we invite, they will come, you know. Invitation, you know. There's prayer for invitation for Buddha and Bodhisattvas. So when we invite, they will come instantly like this. Their body is like mind body, you know, whatever we're thinking, you know. If you have wallet and thinking about your wallet, just like that, you know. If we invite Buddha, they will come like that. All the times. But we are not seeing this our problem. So it means they are witness. And it doesn't matter whether we should be awareness, be alertness, you know. So it means we should not create negative, because if we create negative, then we feel embarrassed because they are not happy, you know. If we do good things, they are happy, it will rejoice. If we do bad things, they will feel shame, you know, because they are witness. And I'm following their path, you know. So if I follow the path, then I should be like Shantideva, you know. I should be following Shantideva's path. So Shantideva is our witness in front of us. So therefore, now this is kind of like alertness, mindfulness. So, then next one is by thinking in this way, I shall mindfully develop sense of shame, respect, and fear. Although, so through this, doing this recollection of Buddha will repeatedly occur. When mindfulness is set with the purpose of guarding the doorway of mind, then alertness will come about, and even which we had gone will return. When just as I am about to act, I see what my mind is tainted with the defilements. At such a time I should remain unmovable like a piece of wood. Never should be looked around distractedly for no purpose with resolute mind. I should always keep my eyes cast towards. So so this is here talking about here. Internal course, right? External course is your teacher, you know, giving you instruction in meditation. Internal course are for these Buddha and Bodhisattvas. And they are the witness. Remember their. And then. If you remember, you know, Buddha, you know, mindfulness of Buddha, you will remember the quality of the Buddha, you know. Quality of Buddha. Buddha means, all Buddha's quality is good, no bad quality, right? Buddha means enlightened being. Enlightened being is 100% good. Good all the time, you know. You can't say sometimes good. Everlasting, you know, because the Buddha is cheap. First, Buddha practiced this precious Bodhicitta mind, right? And practice wisdom realizing two merit, two wisdom, two result. So then he achieved enlightenment because by developing this Bodhicitta mind, then what is the result? Two bodies of the Buddha, right? Form body and the wisdom body. The form body divided into two, right? Sukku and Tulku, means form body divided into two, means emanation body and complete human body. Wisdom body divided into two, right? Wisdom body is truth body, true understanding of the nature of the emptiness of the mind. Completely see all grasping, even subtle dualistic appearance, all completely subside, right? So everything appears to Buddha is dependent arising, no independent arising. Before you realize emptiness, everything appears dependent arising, but remain in absence of dependent arising. So appearance and reality, you know, our mind goes to two directions, right? So because of appearance, so appearance will control our mind. So our mind, almost like 95% go to the appearance and 5% reality. So Buddha means completely enlightened beings. So Buddha is not enlightened beings with this true body, you know, this form body and wisdom body, right? So therefore, when we remember the Buddha, you know, then this will help you to develop your mindfulness. Because good quality, you know, thinking positive will build you good habit. You know, this will plant your good seed. When the seed plant, then it will happen, you know. So this is what we are talking about here. Okay, let's finish. Thank you. Yeah.
Please, could you just explain when you were saying about the dependent arising? That's what you were just saying a second ago.
Dependent arising, you know, everyone knows dependent
yeah.
arising.
When you
dependent
were saying
arising.
When the Buddha.
Buddha. Everything about the Buddha is dependent arising, no independent arising.
Oh, okay, I just what you said.
Independent arising. Is object of negation. The grasping mind object is independent existence. Mm. Emptiness mind object is emptiness. Mm. Wisdom mind object is emptiness. Grasping mind object is independent existence. So independent existence is mistaken grasping, which obscure to see our ultimate reality. So Buddha is completely, so it just means, when you recognize the dependent arising, right, dependent arising, then you will see the grasping is the main troublemaker, his holiness said. Yesterday I listened to his holiness YouTube video, he's giving a speech to him, I think a couple of the last month or something, Gilu conference. And I'm 60 years I practice emptiness, you know. But I can see when I think about the emptiness, right? Then I can see the grasping mind is troublemaker, you know, main troublemaker, you know. Because of because of his all this practice, now I will subdue all this desire object, you know, no problem. Just focus about his holiness, focus about form. We are talking about three realms, right? Form realm, formless realm. Three worlds we are talking about. Desire realm, desire object, his holiness is no problem, you know. This is because of my understanding of emptiness. Now I can control this, you know, this grasping, you know. So it means that when we understand emptiness and dependent arising, is right and left hand, right? Mm. Supporting each other, you know. This is very good Nagarjuna's text in the fundamental wisdom, empty do exist. Mm. Sounds like contradiction, empty. inseparable, you know, in practice. You know, conventional level, right? Conventional, this is conventional level, everything is existing. You know, it's not illusion, you know. Conventional, I can turn the books. Conventional, mirror appears to my mind. Reflection inside the mirror is mirror. You know, I can see my face. Conventional, we do lots of things. But all these, whatever we do, depends on the causes and condition, you know. If they are not depends on the causes and condition, then independent existence. Independent existence, then no need paper, you know, no need factory to make the books. Independent existence. But not. When we analyze the book, then we will kind of like, we can disintegrate the books, you know, one by one, you know. But that's what we are talking about, the madhamika prasanga, all phenomena designated by the mind, many levels by the mind. But it appears to our mind, when we look the book, it appears to our mind not designated by the mind. So these two are connotation. Designated by the mind will dispel the not designated by the mind. Right? These two are connotation. Dispel each other. Thank you.